I have the power. I have the power? Can I have the power, please? Whee!
Hey guys, here with a new video, and today I'm doing, continuing the Masters of the Universe Classics. This guy is actually a bit new. This isn't one of the ones from last year, Dave and I did. This is actually from this year. This is from 2012. It's Fisto. Part of their Subturnia, a little subline. Not much to really show off. It's got your standard Watt mailer. You may notice there's no more tape on the back. There's now this little tiny flap that I have no problem tearing to open this guy up. And one thing I notice is he is in there extremely tight. I actually did take a peek at him early. I got a little gander. But I've never had a figure this shoved into the packaging before. Not sure why. I don't know. But here we got Fisto, who is a manly man. Like, okay, give an idea. If you don't know who Fisto is, I don't know how this relates to the original series or anything like that, but in the 2002 series, they made this guy the brother of Duncan. So, you thought Duncan was manly with his little stash there? You thought he was a manly beast? Check out that beard. That is a manly man right in there. Yeah. And you look at his little name there. Heroic hand-to-hand fighter. With a giant fist. Now his bio, if you want to read the bio, I'm going to put there like I normally do, which is what I do now. His real name, of course, is Malcolm. One thing I really do like is, Duncan brother, served with King Miro, served with Randor, blah, 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 blah. He was stricken with magical amnesia. Ain't it always amnesia? It's always amnesia with these guys. But yeah, there's the bio if you do want to read it. It's interesting to an extent. But, there he's in his little packaging, so we're going to, only thing we really can do. And here's Fisto out of packaging. And, oh boy. This guy is really the perfect example of what I enjoy about this line. You get Fisto right here. Okay, this is Fisto. This is basically him in his vintage look, which is fine and dandy. I actually like how this looks quite a bit. But his accessories are really, really fun. First, you get his vintage sword, which looks great. But you also get some little goodies. You get the belt he wore in the 2002 series that fits over his regular belt. You get his 2002 styled head with this little added headband on it, which I know it's not really a headband, but you can see how it looks there. And you also get his giant freaking sword. Really, really big sword. I'm not certain, but I think his original 2002 figure was supposed to come with the sword, and it didn't. I do know it's a really big deal that the sword is actually released with this figure, because I think it's the first one we've ever gotten all of his accessories together, something to that extent. If you look on the sword, it actually does have a little fist on the handle. So that's neat. That's a neat little feature. The sword, of course, can fit on his back just like that if you do want it to be displayed like that. Just a nice big sword. You can take that off again. And the smaller sword, there's not really a place to store it, which I think could bum some people up. I mean, you could have it kind of like that. It does fit a little loosely, but, you know, whatever. For this belt, just undo it. Dress me. Okay, calm down. I'll get you dressed. We gotta get you going to school. Yay! Yeah, I know. You can put his belt on. And I really do like how that looks. I'm definitely going to have him display with that belt. The heads, I'm not too certain yet. I really like both of them. And I'm not sure which one I actually like more. I don't know. You see the beard's actually a different sculpt, it appears, too. I'm not sure really which one I like more, but for the sake of the video, we'll go ahead and pop off the old one and put on the new one. And you can see there, there's how he looks. All decked out with his 2002 gear. Just like that. Yeah. Yeah, he looks cool. I like him. Now the fist is actually removable, which I didn't expect. You gotta pull really, really hard. And once you hear that pop, you get it off. And I do kind of wish we had gotten an alternate hand up like that would plug in there. The fist doesn't actually even plug in his hand. It's plugged onto his wrist guard. So you can just take it off. You can put it right back on. It does pop when it comes off, but you put it back on. It's just as simple as that. I do kind of wish there was an alternate hand to stick on there just to give him a little bit, you know, just, oh, look at him kind of thing. Before I do take the belt off again, just so you have all the detail on, all the little pouches. He's also little stuff on there. It's detailed really nicely. Has a slight metallic finish on it, but it's not quite as silvery as this golden hand here, which isn't really gold. You can, of course, take his armor off. Just undo the little tabs back there. And then there's two more right over here. And that comes right off. I think you have to take its head off for that. And there you go. Does look kind of silly because he has this metal gut, which looks kind of odd. But one thing that I'm seeing now, actually, if you look on his arm, that's a really cool detail. This arm, you see, it's your standard He-Man pretty much arm. This one, it's got a really deep vein going through it, and it actually looks a lot bulkier than that one. Yeah, it's actually bulkier. He has more muscle in this arm. I think it said that he's actually about as strong as He-Man in one of the cartoons. So that's, it's kind of cool actually that his fist arm has this vein go through. It's severely bulked up. I really do like that. And I'm going to go ahead and get him dressed. Let's get him ready. I'm not going to do any weird voices this time. That'd be kind of awkward. It's weird when you talk to your toys. It is. I'm going to say, yeah, when you have videos that you're doing of your toy, especially if you are undressing them in front of a camera, it's awkward. It's awkward. I'm going to tell you, it's awkward to talk to them. It's awkward to do all that kind of stuff with them. But I do it anyway because they like being comforted. As for the heads, I am really torn on which head I like more. I honestly don't know, but I think I'm going to stick with this one just for the time being. Get it back on there. But yeah, there's Fisto. You can, of course, take a sword. His hand looks like it's really tight again, so we're going to just kind of wedge it open. Stick it inside if I can. So you can have him going, you know, for that look if you want. Which isn't bad. There's a really nice metallic finish on the blade. It does it really good in the light. But, I think I kind of like this one a bit more. It reminds me a bit of the Buster Sword from a Final Fantasy one of those games. It reminds me a lot of that. And I'm kind of curious if he can actually hold it up in his hand. Because it seems like it's a bit heavy. But there's that. Oh, there we go. He does hold it pretty well. His wrist does kind of feel a little bit loose with it in there. He doesn't have like a really strong super grip on it, but he does hold it pretty well for posing. You can kind of get a kind of, there we go. You can get some stuff going with him. He does look pretty nice with it. Just a really nice looking figure overall. I like this guy. I really do. It one of those things, I have no attachment to the character. I know a little of his bio, I know bits and pieces here and there, but I didn't really feel anything for the character, but I really do like how this looks. Just the overall detail on him just stands out really, really well. Articulation-wise for him, I probably should get to the articulation and wrap this whole thing up, because I've been talking for quite a while. He has your standard bit. He's the same as all the other figures, and that little tab is coming undone. Mm-mm, that's not good. That's not good at all. He's busting at the seams. But full articulation. The arms can rotate. I think it's got to the sides nice and far. Bicep can rotate. He has an elbow joint. Wrist can rotate. That wrist can rotate. His head's on a ball joint so he can wiggle around. He can kind of glare at you as you play with his beard. He has the ab crunch, and this whole thing is rubbery, so he can still pose with it, but it looks like the more you pose it, the more you're going to pop the armor off. So I do kind of, if you leave the belt off, if that would actually kind of stop that from happening. I kind of doubt it, but he is poseable, even though he has his armor piece on, which I do like. Maybe it's just that top peg's not fully gripping it. Maybe that's what the issue is. I don't know. Let's see. That's still about as bad. But anyway, the ab crunch is still there. The waist can rotate. The legs can go forward. They can go back. They can swing it to the sides. They can rotate. He can bend at the knee. His boots can rotate. His ankles have that full movement, although they are very, very stiff, which I didn't expect. And then, of course, have the little pivot action. I like this guy a lot. Of course, like always, as I always have to say with these stupid little videos, he is sold out through ManaCollector.com. And if you do want to buy him, you will have to go to sites like Big Bad Toy Store, Amazon, eBay. You can find people that have him online and are selling him, and you can get one from them. Because Maddie's out. They're sold out. And being that he is a recent release, I really don't think there's going to be a chance of him getting reissued anytime soon. So if you do want this guy, I'm having an issue with that armor piece. I really, really am. I don't know. We're gonna hide it. We're just gonna have him just, you know, just. Yep. Nothing going on there. Nope, nothing at all. I would say pick him up. He is really nice, and he does look good with his brother Duncan. They can hang out and talk about their manly adventures together. And, yeah, that's all I can really say. Pick it up. I like it. Super long video. Really long. I probably should end it now, so I'm going to go. Thanks for watching, guys, as always, and I will see you around. Take care.